The activities with Sue. Oh, this week we're going to work on the upper body. So make sure that you've got your pieces of equipment ready, balls or your socks, your bins. And I've also got my door here because I'm going to use that door. Make sure you're in a nice safe space and you're not going to knock any ornaments. And you can always pause me, rewind, or fast forward to the next activity. So, are we ready? 1 foot forward, 1 foot back. Hands close to the cheeks. Some of you all know this. This is one of my warm-ups I do on Pump Week at tennis. Okay, so here we go. Hands ready. Start bouncing. Are you ready to punch out? Brilliant. Punch really forward. You can always join in, mums and dads. Here we go. Oh my God. Heel to toe on your foot so you don't damage your knees. Here we go. That's it. Really rotate.
Rising up, back on the street.
Brilliant. Are you joining in, brothers and sisters? Run on, grandmans. Don't forget, you can always do it from a seating position. Again, punch. As we do in tennis, get nice boxing feet, lightweight feet. Okay, are we ready? Let's get the music. Put your socks, let's carry on. Tap, tap, tap. You can just tap on the top, or you can go into a bit of a skip. Tapping the ball. Brilliant.
Your heart rate up.
love that one. If you know me at tennis, that's one of our fun ones. Okay, so the next one we're going to do, we're going to bring in the ski jumping. Now you can use your socks, okay, but I'm using the toilet rolls this time. I'm going to do some ski jumping because it's quite safe with this. So I've got my toilet rolls with my cloth on top. This is quite a tough one, but if you stand on it, you'll only crush the toilet rolls. Okay, so feet together, skiing arms, we call this the ski jump, and then you're going to bend your knees, push up and over your ski hurdle. Ready? Hup! Woo! And again, feet together and push up. Now if you're in a chair, somebody can hold in the poles and you're just lifting your legs over and then over. Okay, are you ready? So let's have a practice. Remember, age or 30 second challenge, 1 minute challenge, quite tough. Challenge your family. So repeat and then push over and then push over. And we call that the ski jump. Should we do it to some music? Just gets us in the mood, doesn't it? This is for Mrs. Donoghue. Are you ready? She'll like this one. Are we ready? You ready? Watch on the spot. You ready to ski jump? Drink. Okay. Right, next one, we're going to do some upper bodies now. Now, it's a little bit, it's called the plank, but we're doing half a plank. So you can do the full plank if you like. It's quite challenging, or you can just go into the press up position. So all you're going to do now is using the big ball, okay, and you're just going to push it. Now you can work with family member, or you like me, I'm just going to use my door. And then I'm just going to push it in like so with the ball. You can also use the socks so you don't upset your family banging. And then you can use the socks to do that. So you can do it from a plank position, a press up position. You can do it from a plank position or a knee position. Or if you want, just go down on your knees. So you can choose, because it's different levels here. Okay, I'm going to go from my hands and knees here and doing it this way. So we do it to some music. Ooh. Here we go. Are you ready? Have you got your equipment ready? Let's press the music. Here we go. Pushing. Reaching. So we're going to do some seat up work. So I've got my bin of goodies and my water close by. I'm also doing it from sitting with my back to the radiator. You could do it further away. You're just engaging the core a lot more using your sitting up muscles. Okay, so I've got my dishcloth. You can use tea towels or towels. You'll need a bit of a shiny floor like kitchen floor or the bathroom, or you might have wooden floors like me. Okay, so these are great for sliding. So you're going to extend your legs and then bring them up, extend, bring up, extend, bring up. Okay, so when you're rowing, you've got to go out with your legs and then pull your legs in and then out. Should we ever go to music? Are we ready? This is a good fun one. Ready? It's quite fast. Just get you in the mood. Like I say, you can do it from the wall, sit upright. That's it. Well, I'm going back again. Brilliant. Keep pulling them in. Ooh, I can feel my legs now. Are you ready? Now I want you to move. And that's using your core and your legs. And then pull yourself back. And then again, just try and make yourself move. And back. And again. Move when you pull your legs in and your bottom. And push yourself back. That's a good one. Or you might just want to just keep bringing your legs in. You might want to support your legs coming in. Oh, you're getting the floor polished. It or back to the rowing. You can try this on your age or 30 second challenge, but you got to do it right. Okay, loosen up a bit. Oh. So that's a nice one that you can do. I can feel my quads kicking in there. I can feel my core kicking in with me sitting upright. Again, you can use the wall or the radiator, and then the sliding of this is engaging. So that's one. I know a lot of you are swimmers. So this is a good one. Okay, now you can do it, it's a little bit like the wall one, so you can do that one, but you're going to slide back this time. You're not going forward, you're going back. Okay, you can do it again from this position, sliding. Yeah, you can do two together. That'll work on your shoulders for the butterfly. So you can go one, two, like that. You can do it from a press-up position, but pulling back. Instead of you going forward this time, you're going back. Are we ready? Should we do it to music? It'll get us in. Oh, what have we got now? Here we go. Oh, a bit of happy, yeah. Back. When you're doing two, just do it from. Oh! See, your parents are going to get you mopping them and polishing the floor. Yeah, on there again, press up. Oh, that's a good one. There. Yeah. Another one, you can go out, wash on, wash off, and again you can do that from a press up. Wash on, wash off. And if you're finding that difficult in that position, just use seating position, polishing the floor. Or, wash on. Like you're swimming on. And there's different ways that you can use. You can even mop your brow. Woo! Ah, just seeing the time. Doesn't it go quick when you're having fun? Hope you enjoyed that. So I did say last week I'd go through the juggling with you. So this week I've found three socks, okay, three different colours. So last week I just asked you to go into the corner, let it drop into the red, into the corner. So I go one, two. One, two, woo. So sending it into the corners, just a head height, one, two. Now, bringing in the third ball, I'm right-handed, so I'm going to start with my right, okay? And I have it in my fingers in this one, in my palm, that one. And then I throw the stripy one. It's going to land into this hand, but before it does that, I've got to send it in that corner, and then before it lands in that hand, so we go. Woo! Let's start again. Oh, I need a bit of practice. See, socks are great because you can really, there we go. Watching the balls at the top. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. I've got to try and do 50. I'm going to work on that, see if I can do 50 for next week. Have a go. Show me a video if you can do it. And there's a prize on the way if you can do your age of juggling three balls. And same for you parents, if you can do that, that's great. Have a nice week. Hope you've enjoyed the session today. Bye. Bye.